We're going to figure out how to find the distance between two points in the plane, and from that we will discover the distance formula. So here's an example. Find the distance between negative 3, 5, and 6, negative 2. Now, one way of doing this is going ahead and plotting these points on the xy plane here. So let's see, negative 3, 5. Here's negative 3, 5 is right here. Okay. So that's the point negative 3, 5. And then we've got 6, negative 2. So that's over 6 and down 2. And that's the ordered pair 6, negative 2. So what we're trying to find out is the straight line between those two points. What's that exact distance? So I'm looking for this distance d. All right, well, let's see. How about if we try to make a right triangle here? All right, and this is assuming you already know the Pythagorean theorem. So you have two legs of a triangle, and if you take the length of one side squared plus the length of the other side squared for the legs, that's equal to the hypotenuse squared. And the distance, that's really the hypotenuse of this triangle. So how long are each of these sides? Well, let's see, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 spaces here. And along the x-axis here, on the horizontal direction, I've got 3 plus an extra 6, I've got 9 spaces there. So if we use the Pythagorean theorem, I could say that the hypotenuse squared, d squared, okay, equals 7 squared plus 9 squared. So d squared equals 49 plus 81. So d squared equals 130, right? So that's the square of the distance. I want to know what d is, so we take the square root of both sides. Now, when you normally take the square root, you put the plus or minus sign in front of the square root sign. But of course, this is a distance, so distance can't be negative. So we would say that distance is the square root of 130. And that's exactly how long that side is. It can't be simplified. And you could get out a calculator and round it. So if you want to know approximately how long that is, you would get out your calculator and round it to the nearest tenth. It's about 11.4. So first of all, the hypotenuse is always longer than either of the other sides, but it's always shorter than the sum of the two sides, right? Because the long way would be to walk 7 plus 9. So this is the short distance. So look at the picture, and that seems reasonable that the distance is about 11 and a half. All right, so the exact answer here is square root of 130. The approximate distance, rounded to the nearest tenth, is 11.4. Now, if you want to find the distance between two points, you don't always want to have to get out a piece of graph paper and do it this way. So it'd be nice if we had some sort of formula to use, especially imagine if these are really large numbers like negative 300, 568. You know, you wouldn't want to have to try to draw that. One other point that you can write down is this point here at the right angle. What ordered pair is that? It's negative 3, right? And it's down negative 2. So notice it's the x coordinate for that point, and it's the y coordinate for that point. Now, what about the distances here? How would we get 9? Well, look at the x values here. See, these two points are up at the same height or down at the same place, if you want to think about it, negative 2 spaces. But what is that distance? Well, it's going where x is negative 3 all the way over to 6. So we've got 3 places plus 6 more spaces. That makes sense. That's 9 spaces. Could we use these x values to get that answer? It's really the larger number of x minus the smaller number. So notice that was just 6 minus the negative 3. That's another way to get 9. The same thing will happen if I wanted to get this y value of 7 right here. How would we do that without counting spaces? The x value is the same, but it's the y values that are different. So I've got the larger y value minus this smaller y value, 5 minus negative 2. Okay, so that's another way to get the distance. So if you know what the larger number is, the larger x value here, along here, you could take the larger one minus the smaller one. If you're not sure, like if you're working with variables, just keep in mind that 6 minus negative 3, if you take the absolute value of it, it's the same thing if you did negative 3 minus 6. In other words, if you subtract the other way around, as long as you put the absolute value signs around it, it's going to be the same thing. It's important to pay attention to. So we're going to use some of these ideas to get a formula if we are going to use variables for your points, right? So in other words, if we have x1, y1, we're not sure where it is in the plane, but we're going to try to use the same ideas I have here to go ahead and use the Pythagorean theorem and get a distance formula. So here's the problem. Find the distance between x1, y1, and x2, y2. Well, the problem is I really don't know where those are in the plane, but let's just say there's some point, x1, y1, and there's some other point, x2, y2. Now keep in mind, it really might not be lower, it might be up higher at this point. You really don't know. The x1, y1 could be to the right of where the x2, y2 is, so I have to be very careful to realize that it might not look exactly like this. But our goal is to find the distance between those two points. So I'm going to make a right triangle again, and I'm going to try to figure out what this ordered pair is right here. Okay, so if I was in the xy plane, how far over is this? Now, what would the x value be for this point here? Well, it's over the same distance as this point up here, the x1, y1. So the x coordinate has to be x1 at that place. And what's the y value? It's as high as that y value over here, y2. Now, the question is, how long is this horizontal segment here? Okay. Well, the y values are the same, but there's a difference of the x values. You really don't know if x2 is to the right of x1. In this picture it is, but I wouldn't know in general. But I know it's the difference of the x and the y values. So I'm just going to write it's the absolute value of the difference, because that way it'll be a positive number. And we know distances have to be positive. So if I don't put the absolute value around it, I might end up with a negative number. All right, how about this distance over on the side here? Well, that's the difference of the y values. Again, from the picture, it looks like y1 is above y2, but it might not be in general. So again, it's going to be the difference of the y values, but I'm going to put an absolute value around it so it's clear that it's a positive number. Distance has to be positive. Okay, now we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem. We know that if you take the square of one leg plus the square of the other leg, it equals the distance squared. So that's what I'm going to write. I'm going to write the distance squared is going to be the square of one of the legs. Let's take this horizontal leg here first. So it's going to be x1 minus x2. Now, it's really an absolute value, but when I square it, it'll end up being positive anyway. So I could put an absolute value around that x minus x2 and then square it. But if x1 minus x2 was negative, as long as I square it, I'm going to get the same number here. So you could check that out for yourself. If you do 3 minus 5 and then you square it, you're going to get the same thing as if you do 5 minus 3 and then square that number. Plus. All right, now that's this. The length of that leg squared plus the length of the other one squared, and same reasoning, I could put y1 minus y2 squared. So it's important to notice it really doesn't matter if I write x1 minus x2 or x2 minus x1. I basically have to subtract the x coordinates and square it, add it to, I have to subtract the y coordinates and then square it. Almost done. To find the distance, we just take the square root of both sides. So it's x1 minus x2 squared plus y1 minus y2 squared. Now, in algebra books, you'll almost always see it written like this: d equals the square root of x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. But it really doesn't matter. The trick is, in one parenthesis, you've got to subtract the x values and square it, and it doesn't matter the order, because if you switch the order, it just means it'll be the opposite. So instead of being a positive 2, it might be a negative 2. Once you square it, it'll be the same number. So as long as you're squaring it, it really doesn't matter the order. So these are exactly the same formula, and you should convince yourself of that by putting in some numbers if you want. So let's go up back to that very first problem, and now we're going to use the distance formula. So let's go back to the original problem. So this was our original problem: find the distance between negative 3, 5 and 6, negative 2. And when we did it before, we found it was square root of 130. So now we're going to use the formula. Okay, so there's where people say, well, which one's x1 and which one's x2? Well, it doesn't really matter. What matters is that you're going to subtract the x values. I don't like working with negative numbers. It's easier for me to work with positive numbers. So here's how I set it up. I put the square root, put a parenthesis with a minus sign in the middle, and then square it. Add it to some other parentheses with a minus sign squared. And now I'm going to fill in the x values. To make sure what is in parentheses will be positive, I just put the bigger value of x first. All right, so the bigger value of x in these two ordered pairs is 6, so I'm going to put 6 before the minus sign and a negative 3 after it. Notice if you did it the other way, if you put a negative 3 first and then you did minus 6, you're going to get negative 9. And when you square it, you're going to get 81, which is what I'm going to get as well. All right, now let's take the other ordered pairs, and we've got to look at the two y values. And again, just because I like to have whatever's in parentheses ending up being a positive number, I'm going to put the bigger value of y first, 5 and negative 2. Now you're going to say, that's really not the formula. You are absolutely right. The formula does say x1 minus x2 and y1 minus y2, but you can always switch and write y2 minus y1. It's not like the slope formula where it makes a lot of difference. So if you put the negative 2 minus 5, as long as you square it, you're going to get the same thing I do. So this will be, well, I have to simplify inside parentheses first. That's order of operations. So I've got 9 squared plus 7 squared. Of course, if you put in the values for x and y in a different order, you would have maybe a negative 9, and you'd have to put a parentheses around that negative 9 before you squared it. So this is the square root of 81 plus 49. You still have to add inside parentheses, I'm sorry, underneath the square root, and you're still going to get the square root of 130. Now, if you want to take this and fill in it exactly, calling this first order pair x1, x2, the second order pair 6, negative 2, so that's x1, y1, x2, y2, plug it in exactly as I've written it. When all is said and done, you should also get the square root of 130. We'll do some more problems on another video.